The holy grail of dinosaur fossils has been found in the Sahara Desert. Researchers have unearthed the remains of a long-necked, four-legged, school bus-sized titanosaur that lived roughly 80 million years ago. The plant-eating Cretaceous-period dinosaur, named Mansurosaurus shianae, was nearly 33 feet long and weighed 5.5 tons. Very few fossils have been unearthed from the last days of the dinosaurs in Africa, and the latest discovery sheds light on this missing history. The find also reveals that at least some dinosaurs could move between Africa and Europe during the final days of the dinosaurs. Scientists say the dinosaur is an incredible discovery. The skeleton is the most complete ever unearthed on the continent, from the end of the Cretaceous. It includes parts of the skull, the lower jaw, neck and back vertebrae, ribs, most of the shoulder and forelimb, part of the hind foot and pieces of the bony skin plates. Co-author Dr. Matt Lamina, of Carnegie Museum of Natural History in New York, said, "When I first saw pictures of the fossils, my jaw hit the floor. This was the Holy Grail, a well-preserved dinosaur from the end of the age of dinosaurs in Africa, that we paleontologists had been searching for a long, long time." Co-author Dr. Eric Gorskak, of the Field Museum in Chicago, said, "Africa's last dinosaurs weren't completely isolated, contrary to what some have proposed in the past. There were still connections to Europe." African dinosaur fossils from the late Cretaceous, 100 to 66 million years ago, are few and far between. Dr. Gorskak explained, "Mansurosaurus shianae is a key new dinosaur species, and a critical discovery for Egyptian and African paleontology. Africa remains a giant question mark in terms of land-dwelling animals at the end of the age of dinosaurs. Mansurosaurus helps us address long-standing questions about Africa's fossil record and paleobiology. What animals were living there and to what other species were these animals most closely related? Much of the land where their fossils might be found is covered in lush vegetation, rather than the exposed rock of dinosaur treasure troves such as those in the Rocky Mountains, the Gobi Desert or Patagonia. The lack of a late Cretaceous fossil record in Africa is frustrating for paleontologists since the continents were undergoing massive geological and geographic changes at the time. During the earlier years of the dinosaurs, in the Triassic and Jurassic periods, all the continents were joined together as the supercontinent of Pangaea. But in the Cretaceous they began splitting apart and shifting towards the configuration we see today. It hasn't been clear how well connected Africa was then to other southern hemisphere land masses and Europe, or to what degree its animals may have been cut off from their neighbors and evolving on their own separate course. Mansurosaurus, as one of the few African dinosaurs known from this period, helps answer that question," reports Nature Ecology and Evolution. Dr. Salem said, "What's exciting is our team is just getting started. Now we have a group of well-trained vertebrate paleontologists here in Egypt, with easy access to important fossil sites. We expect the pace of discovery to accelerate in the years to come." Titanosaurs are famous for including the largest land animals that ever roamed Earth, such as Argentinosaurus, Dreadnoughtus and Patagonidon. But Mansurosaurus was moderate-sized for a titanosaur, roughly the weight of an African bull elephant. Dr. Dina Smith, a program director in the National Science Foundation's Division of Earth Sciences in the U.S. which part-funded the research, said, "The discovery of rare fossils like this sauropod dinosaur helps us understand how creatures moved across continents, and gives us a greater understanding of the evolutionary history of organisms in this region."